It was during World War II. Millions were killed in concentration camps. His parents were two of those millions who shared the same fate. Many experiments and exterminations was proceeded by Dr. Schienzel, Joseph Mengele's secret right arm. He managed to escape.
This has to be the most depressing thing I have ever seen in my life.
And all he sees is revenge. His name is Kropotkin Vladimir, and this is his story.
Well, that was horrifyingly depressing. What's going on, everybody? Your host, AMF1534, here. Welcome to Let's Play the Forgotten Ones. This is a game that I was looking around through Steam's library a couple days ago, and I came across this, and this is really loud, I apologize. But when I saw the trailer for it, it had a very Cry of Fear-esque quality to it. And for anybody that had seen me do a series of that game a while back, that game was awesome. I had a blast doing it. And so I figured, you know what? This game was free to play. I'll download it and give it a shot and see how it goes. And, well, you know what? It's also October, and that is the month of scary things. So I think that it's time for us to give it a whirl. And I think we may be in for a treat. It got mixed reviews, but I think I'll have to be the judge of that one. And after that extremely chipper opening sequence there, I think we're going to be having a good one. So here we go, my friends. Totally blind run, because that's what horror games are all about. Don't miss while shooting. Your life is at stake. You don't say. I thought the point of games was to completely miss them on purpose. You're just supposed to strike fear into them by not hitting them. Burnt Andreas... I couldn't even read most of that. That was a terrible looking graphic. I mean, this could be one of those games that it's so bad that it's good, or it could just be one of those games that it's so bad that it's bad. I don't really know which one it's gonna be, but we'll see. Welcome to Gorobushkina's hometown, where all of the cars are very old, and he's just sitting very depressing, like, in his office that has terrible lighting.
I found the info you're looking for. The man you see is located in the old swastika board. I can't provide...
Are you saying the swastika board?
Travel there on your own responsibility.
Great to hear. I'll get in the way immediately. I owe you.
Okay, I think one thing I might want to invest in doing is turning subtitles on if that's at all possible, because I couldn't hear really any of that very well. Okay, we need to have, like, the game volume go down a little bit, because it's fucking loud. As goes with... We'll put that down at, like, we'll put it at 69. Oh, yeah. How's about... Okay, we really aren't going to get anything in the way of subtitles, are we? Aha! There you are. I see what's up. Third-person dialogue, yes. Alright, I don't know what... Oh, view bobbing would probably be just... some other shit. Okay, here we go. I know that. For the love of God. Okay, thank you. Jesus. Okay, let's see if the controls... Uh-huh, they are. Alright. They're just like Cry of Fear. You save past experiences in this journal, you may as well save yours in the journal too. Well, I can't do that right now because I can't. Okay, you know what? Real quick, let's look at some of the other keyboard bindings. I just want to make sure that I've got everything down here. Okay. Alright. Okay. Alright, everything looks, for the most part, pretty normal. Alright, we're looking good here. Just had to get everything under control. I think it's time to probably get out of this room, I would imagine. Bum bum bum! I love how forceful he is with these things. It's locked. Well, this one's not. Can't have both of them. The entire game's just you're stuck in your office. Alright, well, I guess we'll go this way. He was pointing that direction, so it just makes me feel like that's the way we're supposed to go. With this glowing note on the ground. All written in red pen like we're in grade school. Hello and welcome to the Forgotten Ones. Before you close this note, there's a few things you should know. Okay, so it's... somebody just left a random letter in here. Just ominously giving us all the tools to the game. Alright. Not like we wouldn't have just figured that out on our own. The inventory will allow you to browse through items. Use items you must... blah, 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 blah. You must click the use button. There's also a drop button, which you should use if your inventory is full. Okay. Thanks a lot for nothing, because I already figured that out on my own. Okay, let's go into this. Can we go in here? Another locked door. Okay. Better question, why is this note on the floor over here? Why wasn't that in my office? That would have made much more sense for that to be in my office. Okay, that door's locked too. I don't know why we're getting that weird, like, it looks like a scan line in the middle of the screen every time we walk. I don't know why that is. Maybe it'll go away later on. Who knows? So we don't really know... I should get to the car. Okay. I don't like the way he picks things up. It's weird. Also, where does this guy work? He just... working everywhere? Or like a maybe like a detective's office or something? Autriche, if that's even how you say it. I don't really know much about my foreign languages. Just kind of browsing through here to make sure there's nothing important. There's, like, nothing here. This is obviously at a time before there were computers available. Obviously. This was directly after World War II. Probably not going to really have much going on in that department. Uh-huh. Alright. Boy, look at that. God, that thing's like a fucking monster truck. Always watch our back. Death is the first step to survive. Wait, death is the first step to survive? Like, you have to die in order to live? Is that what you're saying? You're never alone in the dark. God, there's too many tips going on! I can't read them all! Are we, like, near death?
It was over okay. 20 years ago, when I was first brought to this forest. I didn't know what was going on.
I'm also impeding the speed limit vastly right now.
I'm stopping this mission with a man named Shinzo and Gregor. But I go out of us the button, and Shinzo seemed to be the boss. Then a little about you. But as always, eventually you will deal with person's personal.
As always, I really enjoy mumbling to myself in third person in the car. It just calms me down after a long day at work at my nondescript job that nobody can tell what it is. Wait a minute, if they're in Europe, why is he driving on the left side? Usually most European cars you drive on the right side, isn't it? Or is that only in certain European countries? This road has been blocked. Perhaps this trail... Oh, great! Fantastic. And now it begins. Didn't take long. So happened to have somebody cutting down trees in the middle of the road, and then the car exploded. So wait, do we have a flashlight? I think having a flashlight would be a really good idea. I don't remember seeing that in here anywhere. I don't think that's anywhere, actually. Flashlight. Alright, we're gonna be operating without a flashlight. Also, I apologize if things are a little bit too loud, guys. I'll have to check it out in post. and see, you know, I'll have to adjust the audio a little bit, because I would imagine that parts of this are going to be louder than they should be. Okay, here we go. Yes, just start pointing your gun at the sky when you start running. That makes plenty of sense. You may accidentally shoot yourself in the face, but... Oh, we have a sprint meter. I didn't notice that. It is also incredibly dark. Doesn't help that I also have a, I got a little bit of a glare on my screen here. If you ride this bike, you will die. So don't. It's not a very good idea. What was the point of coming in here? There was literally no sense in coming here. One thing I do like so far is that they obviously, they really wanted to start putting in the ominous, creepy music, which is always a good thing. And there's an American flag out here. Great.
It smells like shit down here.
It smells like shit down here, and it's extremely dark. And that's always the makings for something great. That's just positive as all fucking get out, and I can't see anything. Dude, I'm not gonna like any part of this. I can't fucking see anything. Okay, is there, like, actually a light in here? Oh, whoa. Okay. Alright. It's a very bad choice to touch that. What the fuck? I can't see a damn thing in this room. How do you expect me to do anything in here if I can't see? Oh, okay. That's just aiming down the sights. I literally have no idea what I'm looking for in there. I can't fucking see anything. Okay, there's gotta be... Oh. Mm-hmm. Okay. I read ya. I see what's up. I should have realized the glowing torch on the floor last time. That would have been a great idea. Let me get... I should have known. I was gonna say, let me guess, there's gonna be a secret door of some kind in here. What's up with the radio? Well, you know, some people just need to listen to the radio while they're taking a shit. I mean, I do it all the time, except for it usually involves me just playing games on my phone. Oh my god, okay, I was gonna say, you can't tell me you're gonna be going, like, a third of a mile an hour. The fuck was that? I saw something fall. Didn't look like a very good thing there. I think we're gonna need that axe, but they won't let me have it, so I guess we're not taking it. Oh. Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Give me that thing. Yeah. Sounds good. I do... Oh, great. I didn't realize all the body bags in here. That's not very good. And why did someone block the door? Can't open that. Alright, here we go. Let's find out something new. I couldn't stop thinking. I'm worried about my brother. I left him for dead in the tunnel. I could have talked him out of it, but he was too obsessed. He couldn't accept it. We couldn't save them, I told him. I was chased. I was terrified. If you're still out there, I want you to know that I blood. Great. So he died in the middle of writing that, and then... Whoa. What the fuck was that?
Get away from me!
What the fuck was that? I did not like that, whatever it was. Well, here we go. I guess we're gonna have to do something involving moving these things away. In one form or another. We can't open these? They're all locked. Who actually locks these things? Nobody ever locks stall doors when there's nobody in them. That has, like, happened a total of zero times ever. Okay, so maybe we need to shoot these? Is that what's going on? I can't... Yep. Whoa. Dude, come on. I don't need this in my life right now. Okay. I'm gonna say, this better not be like Cry of Fear, where you better use every fucking bullet inside of the clip, otherwise you're in deep shit. It actually looks like it will allow you to reload normally, in a way that makes sense, and that's always good. Oh, yeah. Yeah, let's go down to good old-fashioned shit lake. See what goes on. So can we... Okay, we can't save like that. We have to do it in the same way that we do in Cry of Fear. Alright, guys. Well, you know what? This looks like a decent place to stop for now. When we come back on the next episode of Let's Play the Forgotten Ones, we're going to see what it was that was knocking on the door in the bathroom. So hopefully it's not going to be something that's dead that's trying to kill me. I'm sure it will be, though, because why wouldn't it be at this point? So until then, my friends, this is your host, AMF1534, saying thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys decide to stick around, because this looks like it's going to be both a blend of interesting and fucking weird. So until then, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.